Like, we don't do it for you, sweaty. This is for us.
You're new.
Yes, you do.
It's like, for girls, I think it's strictly just for themselves.
Ho bag needs to squat more.
I haven't shaved in 10 years.
Yeah, do not answer the door to children dressed like that.
When you first start out, that's like your original goal. Then you go in there, you're like, all right, see what I can flex on today.
Another reason why, like, I've never taken steroids. Just because I know that won't fulfill me. Ladies and gentlemen, Silent Mike here. 10 minutes to win. 11 minutes in heaven. We don't know. Working title of the game show. We're here with the
Gossip
one and only.
Boys.
The Gossip Boys. The Mean Boys. Dean Sidoris of Caffeine Kilos. The legend, Jim McD, 3SB.co. And the one and only, Kale Bro, Kyle. KaleBro.tv, I believe.
Yeah. It's starting to...
Gaming.
Hey, I was on the stream the other night.
Popping.
Kid's got pizzazz.
He does. And, probably the best FPS player to come out of Sacramento.
Damn.
Yeah.
Okay. He doesn't want to see me.
Yeah,
he had 150 people.
Yeah, 150 people the other day.
Yeah, like, okay. I got raided by a bigger streamer. Yeah,
that sounds much more painful than it probably really is in real life. Getting raided.
Raided.
Yeah.
It's, pants on.
It's a panty raid.
Yeah, it's actually a good thing.
Keep your pants on.
Yeah.
It's been said many a time that guys, when they go through heartbreak, women that they go through heartbreak, they get their gym bod and they focus in on themselves. But what I've found through my career here is that you're really only lifting to get the love of your gym bros. Is working out for the opposite sex even like a thing or worth it? Why did you first work out?
Go ahead, Dean.
Go ahead. Jump.
I think 100%.
For the same sex?
No.
For the opposite
hell
sex?
No. I'm not going in there and be like, hey, Dean, look at my fucking chest.
I would suggest that you are doing exactly that thing, and women don't give that much of a shit.
That's what I'm going with next.
But when you first start,
when you first start, you're like,
oh, dude, I'm going to get so much pussy.
I'll piggyback on that. I think when you first start out, that's like your original goal. Then you go in there, you're like, all right, see what I can flex on today.
Yeah. I see Dean lifting more than me. I'm like, dude, this guy's a bitch. I'm going to do more than him.
Yeah.
And then you just go months and months and months. I'm like, okay, we're getting stronger. And then, like, women aren't even there anymore.
You haven't talked to a girl six months later, but you better press 315.
Yeah. You're just blacking out every time you're in there. You don't even see people.
That's true.
Yeah. I think something like that.
What about ladies to guys?
Oh.
You know, I think that they do it for just for themselves. I think it's like for girls, I think it's strictly just for themselves.
Interesting.
I think maybe it is for like a guy's attention, but also girls do it for other girls' attention. Be like, look at that chick. She's her body's banging.
I fit the Lululemons better than Stephanie does.
Yeah.
She doesn't even fill out her Lulus. Ho bag needs to squat more.
I think no matter how cishet anybody is, I think it's always for the same sex. I think it's always
you're probably right.
Intention or result?
I think it's both. Oh. Like, who do you get the most attention from?
For
is the
sure,
question.
Result.
I think you're doing it for both. Then at that point,
maybe it for both. But I think that you get more attention from the same sex,
despite
because of the comparisons. People compare. Yeah. Oh, sure. I got this. I got that. Or whatever. Right. I wish my abs were like yours, or you know, your butt is amazing. You know, nobody really says that, but they think it.
Despite how insecure I am, I do think I'm more secure than the average. And I don't think I've ever lifted to compare to a guy. Another reason why, like, I've never taken steroids. Just because I know that won't fulfill me or make me feel better. And even, who was I talking to? Maybe even you. I've never wanted to be, like, the ultra-jacked guy. Where everyone kind of started that. Like, I want to look like Jay Cutler. I want to look like Ronnie. I never once even...
Yeah, it was never me either.
You know what I mean? No, I understand. Like, I want to be the biggest, baddest dude. I'm an alpha sigma male. And I'm going to show Dean by my bench press that I'm the alpha male in this room. I've never once thought about that.
Then that's just a pure subtopic of the original point.
But I have lifted, for ladies.
So it's like...
Because you think like, if I'm fitter, healthier. But the truth is, I also have a lot of like lady friends. I've just always... I think I was raised by women kind of, so that was kind of the thing.
I've always had... They don't give a crap. No.
Maybe. I don't know if they necessarily like dad bod or fat guys, but like...
I think of the personality and just like the overall, can I be around this person?
And are you like put together? Mm-hmm. Not are you fit? Are you athletic?
Yeah, because you can be fit and just like got nothing going
on. Okay, so with the women thing, are we now branching into the clothing they're wearing too and all that shit?
Maybe. Yeah. What
you're doing it for them still?
Same idea, right? I've never worn a tank in the gym once
in my life.
Because I'm not trying to show to the dude or the girl.
That's the one thing I do. It does kind of piss me off. And they're like, we don't do it for you, sweaty. Like, shit like that. Like, yes, you do.
They
like,
called you sweaty?
No, dude. They just that say, was rude. Like, we don't. This is for us.
Your new nickname is Sweaty?
Yeah.
That does bring
a
good
sweat.
That does bring a good argument to Dean's point, where I do kind of agree women are just tend to be more mature, even though they're just as insecure as us. But they, yeah, why? And guys nowadays, though, at commercial gyms, you couldn't take your shirt off. But every Instagram post in every gym now, that if you train at like a quote-unquote like hardcore gym, every dude's shirtless too. Why are you working out with your shirt off?
Yeah.
And you can say the same for chicks. Like, why are you
buck naked? Now
you don't
have to go into the, group class in the mirror. Not like how the cool gym people at like CalFit or 24, they would go into the
posing room
that's made for just like the group classes and like, oh yeah, you know, I'm a regular here, you know, I go in this room.
I do my ab circuit.
I feel like that could be a whole other question, but
people that
why
go in that room.
Yeah, well, why is it that they take a picture and their shorts are bundled up at their ankles? They look like a fucking penguin.
Yeah,
like, well, I don't understand.
Well, it looks like you're about to take a dookie. Yeah, take your shorts totally off or not. Yeah, they
or
keep
not.
Them at their ankles.
One way or the other. Like,
I don't know why.
Wear undies that you can drop, totally drop trow and look normal in
or
a
like
picture.
If you're not,
or
the biggest thing with posing is if you're not stepping on stage.
It's very weird.
What are you doing?
It's what are you so doing?
What are you doing?
Well, let me get my bump cover off. All right, dude.
What are you doing?
Every time I see that, I think of the guys who... because they were not raised by like normal people, drop their pants all the way to the floor when they're using the urinal.
Another one.
This is what it looks
out. They're just ass out.
The hard tan year round when you don't compete. Also,
yeah,
I get
wild.
That tan makes you look a little more jacked, and we all want to look more jacked. Yeah. And in modern society, being tan is more attractive now. Where, you know, 300 years ago, being pale was. But I'm not going to fake tan year round.
That's a melanin injection.
That too. Melanotan's a real thing, yeah.
Yeah, but it does weird stuff.
Yeah, it's like a peptide.
Makes you look weird.
But it's supposed to be a fat burner, too.
Yeah, it's supposed to make your dick a funny color as well.
Oh, like what?
Like orange.
My dick's already a little.
Like orange.
Carrot dick.
Yeah, exactly.
That's
character.
Not doing it. Yeah.
Yeah, that's not good.
I don't know if ladies care about our six-pack, but they definitely care about our orange dick. Mm,
that's true, yeah.
Yeah, he's got a... Carrot hog.
Yeah. Talk about gossip boys. You're about to be in the gossip girl group chat with your orange ass.
Got a hammer, but I thought it was planted in the ground like a carrot.
Yeah, I was waiting for the green lettuce to
pop
out.
You just
got to
just paint the pubes green.
Oh, that'd be
good. Oh, you got a Dennis Rodman cock?
Halloween, dude. Yeah.
You dress up your peepee?
God. Go to the zone ball, that outfit.
Do not answer the door to children dressed like that. That's all I got to
say. Halloween's not my thing.
You're on my property, kids, you know?
Has anybody in here been to the zone ball?
No, but I've heard about it all growing up. I don't know if it's a thing anymore.
Is it not?
No, but it was.
I've never been, but I always heard it was like shit like that.
It was supposed to be like the Playboy.
What the hell is zone ball?
It was a radio station put on a Halloween
but
party
like for
here.
Adults.
It was like a Playboy type deal.
Oh,
like
right,
people are naked and wiling. And there's
like hooking up.
Yeah, there's an adult room. You're trick-or-treating for condoms.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. I used to go down, I think, at, like, where was that at? Arco?
Or Cal Expo or something. I don't know.
It was legit just like, hey.
We don't know. I've never been. But it was on the radio every year for our thing.
Yeah, too specific for our location, but no one really can relate, kind of. I don't know why I threw that out there.
Because you have an orange dick with green pukes.
I went to zone ball with an orange dick.
It makes me think, though, of Gabe Kapler, the Giants manager right now. Yeah. He's got a thing about, like suntanning your balls.
No, that's
your
a real. No, that'll be a whole other topic. We can't dive down there because that's
man.
A real topic.
Direct vitamin D
down
there.
No, that's a real thing.
Direct vitamin D.
Tanning your balls.
Yeah. Well, they make. I don't want to get too much into it, but they make UV guns specifically for that.
Yeah, there's
so
a large
in the privacy of your house.
Please get into
there's
it.
There's a large population doing it.
Yeah, it's big.
We'll
right
talk
now.
About more dick and balls in the next episode. Sadly, with this one, I don't think there's any winners. We all lose.
We all lost.
We all just are posing for the bros.
I don't know, dude. Carrot dick was good. Carrot dick's pretty good with
carrot
the
dick.
What color?
The lettuce pubes. You got to dedicate because you got to get a few months at least to grow out the lettuce.
Oh, the fro?
That's fair.
I haven't shaved in 10 years.
Yeah.
You got the Bob Marley dick.
Got the Jackie Moon going, dude.
The Jackie Moon. Oh, man.
All I can say is as you get older, it just keeps growing and you got it. Yeah, eventually. Oh.
Really?
Yeah. It's a disaster. It's a total disaster.
It's a total disaster.
If you don't,
it's a nightmare.
Yeah. If you don't trim stuff a little bit, it's a little bit like one of those like old English estates where It's been ignored and like the landscape has grown up. Up into the, you know, the bench seats and the
sheepdog.
Yeah, exactly.
It's got some sheepdog. It's got some history. Those hairs have seen some things.
If these legs could talk.
Yeah. And cut. Yeah, that's it.
Sweet.